Hi guys, what is up? Welcome to my channel. As you can see, we are doing another palette collection video, and today I'm going to be sharing with you all of my affordable eyeshadow palettes that I own. Now, this is going to be anything from Maybelline, and then it's also ranging to like Morphe or some indie brands as well that are more affordable, like Kaleidos or Alamar. So that is what I have. If you are interested, I also have a luxury eyeshadow palette collection video and a high-end eyeshadow palette collection video. I had to break them up to keep me sane, so I will list those two down below for your viewing pleasure. But anyways, as you can see, I do own affordable eyeshadows. I do love affordable eyeshadows. I would say typically I don't really like drugstore eyeshadows. I really struggle with those, but affordable brands like Morphe, ColourPop, BH, those are my jam. I love finding a good quality eyeshadow for cheap, so that is why I have accumulated the collection that I have. So if you are interested in seeing every palette that I own, then just keep watching. Alright, so we are going to start off with my heavy hitters, the brands that I have the most palettes from. And by far, ColourPop wins. You guys know I love my ColourPop palette. So we're going to start off with this palette. This is a palette that I made myself. So I bought the individual palette and then I selected all of these colors. This was a couple years ago, so at this point in time, most of these shades are probably discontinued, which is why I don't really feature this. But I really like the colors I chose. I think I did a pretty good job of developing my own palette. That's that. Next, we have the Bare Necessities, which is one of my favorites from ColourPop, I have to say. It's a lot of unnecessary shades in that a lot of the shades are kind of the same, but also, I mean, I love these colors so much. Like, why not? You know, this is a beautiful neutral palette. So if you're looking for a neutral palette that you can wear every single day from ColourPop that's affordable and worth the value, by far, I recommend this. The last big palette that we have is the So Jaded palette. This is a collaboration with Kathleen Lights, and Kathleen Lights is definitely my favorite big YouTuber. And I love this palette. I just love the variety in shades here. I think it's a very unique palette and it really allows for a lot of creativity. So I love this one. I highly recommend this one as a first ColourPop starter palette because you get a lot to work with in this one. And now we're gonna go into kind of their more traditional style eyeshadow palettes in no particular order. We have this one right here, which is the You're a Cutie palette. This is one of my newer ColourPop palettes that I have. I like it. I don't think the quality in here is amazing, but I think it's really, really pretty. And of course, it is great for the price. It is freaking stunning. So if you like purples and pinks, I do recommend this. It's great for the price. This is an older palette of mine from ColourPop. This is the Double Entendre palette, but truly it's one of my favorites. It's one of my favorites to bring with me when I go out of town because it has every kind of everyday neutral color that I need. So this is one of my favorites. It's one of my most basic ones. It's one of my most highly recommended just because it has every color you kind of need. So I love this one for travel, Double Entendre. This one I have a deep connection with as well. This is the California Love. It is very warm, but it has such beautiful colors and tones in here. I really enjoy this palette a lot. I think the quality is great in here, and it's just a great selection of colors, great variety and ratio as far as finishes go here, and this is a very great, well-rounded palette. We have the Dream Street palette, another Kathleen Lights collaboration. I remember I was so excited for this one. I was in college when she came out with this, and I was in my dorm room ordering this the second that it was available, and it is really pretty. I truly, honestly, don't really use it too often. I do occasionally grab some colors from here because there are some key colors in here that I really enjoy. I don't think this one is super special to the ColourPop line, but it is a really cute palette and I just love Kathleen Lights. Here is the last collaboration from Kathleen Lights. This is the Zodiac. Again, I don't really reach for this one too much either, if I'm being quite honest, but I like this one because it really is a nice variety in shades here. You have neutral options, but you also have some pops of color, which I think Kathleen does a really nice job of, and just her array of colors that she chooses. So I do enjoy this one as well. I think I like Dream Street more than I like this one though, but this one also really cute. All right. Now we have You Had Me at Hello. I love the tones in here because it is very kind of mauve-y toned, and it's got these purples here that I really love to incorporate with the neutrals. The shimmers are all kind of, they have an underlying tone of rose. This one's really pretty. This is an underrated palette in my opinion. I think it's really nice. All right, Sweet Talk, you know, is one of my all-time favorite palettes from ColourPop, if not my favorite. I love the peachy tones in here. I love the packaging. I think it is so detailed. The different textures in here are stunning. The different looks I can get out of here, I really enjoy. I just find it to be an overall very inspiring palette. It's perfect for the spring season. Highly, 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 highly recommend this one. I love Sweet Talk. Then we have the Pretty Guardian palette from ColourPop, which is a Sailor Moon collaboration. And I mean, obsessed with this packaging. How could you not be? It's just the cutest palette ever. It also is a very great palette for spring and summer. It's not my favorite palette from ColourPop, not my favorite array of shades, but it does have a lot more vibrancy to it than a lot of my other ColourPop palettes. So for that, it does kind of lift my mood. So I do enjoy this one as well. Like I said, it's not my favorite, but actually the colors in here, you can actually get a lot of different looks. You can play with purples, you can play with some gold shades, you have some bright pink shades you can play around with. So you actually get a lot more variety in here now that I look at it. The longer I've owned this palette, the more inspired by this palette I have felt. I also have this palette. Now this palette was a pre-curated palette, so these are all individual colors, but I bought them in a bundle and they're all pressed glitter shades. And I know so many of us are strongly against pressed glitters, and at this point in time I don't really use them too often either, but I just wanted to have this for options. I'm not scared of pressed glitter shades, so I do use these on my eyes sometimes, but I don't reach for this one that often. But I wanted this palette just to give me options. I have all of the pressed glitter shades that I need because of this. I remember dying for this palette. This is the She palette. It was in collaboration with Karrueche. Honestly, I don't even think you can get this anymore. I'm not sure. This is really old, but oh my gosh, look at the tones here. I find that the color here, Pool, is very, very pink, like much more pink than it looks in the pan. But I just love these tones and colors. This is one of the first palettes from ColourPop that came out. Not the first, but one of the first. And I mean, it's so feminine. It's so girly. It's so pretty. I love this palette. I think there's a little bit of an imbalance as far as matte to shimmers, because a lot of the shimmers kind of look the same. There's not so much variety, but that's just me being hypercritical. I love this one. It's so feminine and pretty. And then we have the good old very first palette, which is the Yes Please. And look at this, mine is gross and disgusting. I loved this palette. I remember I used it a lot in college because that is when this came out for me. And I mean, it's a really pretty palette. I'm not so into warms anymore, but this is an OG for ColourPop. I don't think I'll ever get rid of it. I'll always have this, not this specific palette, but I'll always have this in my collection because good memories for sure. So we're gonna move on to my nine panners. I made a very big order off of ColourPop a couple of months ago, and I ordered a lot of these nine pan ones that I didn't buy when they first came out. So a lot of these I actually haven't had time to use yet. I think I might dedicate some time over this quarantine to use them, but this first one is Smoke Show. I haven't used it yet. It just looks like the most killer smoky palette ever. I don't really wear smokes, so I know this wasn't a palette I'm going to use a lot, but I bought this on sale, so that's when I took the opportunity. But people seem to love it, and it is very, very unique. So I'm happy to have this in my collection. Going Coconuts, of course, is one of my all-time favorite palettes from ColourPop, if not my favorite. These got a little bit messed up in the pan just because they all fell out and I didn't know where they actually belonged, so I just popped them in. But oh my gosh, if you are more of a cool tone kind of neutral lover, you're going to love this palette. This is absolutely one of my favorite palettes from them. I love this one. We have It's My Pleasure. It's been a while since I've used this one, but it's a very pretty purple. I enjoy the different kind of tones of shimmers you have in here. You have some duochromes, and I mean, it's not a super special purple palette in my opinion. I do like it. It's not my favorite, but if you are on the market for an all purple palette that's affordable, this one's great. Wait till ColourPop has a sale. You can get this for like $6 or something, $9, something crazy like that. We have Honey, and this one seemed to be super popular, so I picked it up. I have not yet had the chance to use it, but I can see myself bringing it out this summer. What drew me to this palette were these colors right here, because I think they did a really good job of putting flattering colors for yellows in here that aren't actually pure yellow. So I'm excited to give this one a go. I can't believe I haven't used it yet. That's crazy. I need to just dedicate a week to wearing these nine pan ones. We have Lilac You or Not. You can tell if I've used them or not based on whether this or not is in here, but I think I like this better as far as color story wise to It's My Pleasure, because I'm such a lavender fan. So I'm excited to give this one a go. It does look very similar to It's My Pleasure, but there's something about this that I like better. So I'm excited to try this out. Baby Got Peach. This is a fun one. I really like this one. I've used this one a few times. It does remind me of Sweet Talk a lot, but it is a more condensed version and it's a little bit different. It definitely is. This one is much, much, much more peach, but these are really great tones for the spring and summer. And if you're looking for a nine panner, this one is stunning. I love it. And I know people don't like pressed glitters, but I think this glitter is a really, really nice touch. Then we have Just My Luck, which I bought to use this St. Patrick's Day, but then coronavirus obviously took that away from me, which is fine. I can't believe I didn't use this even on St. Patrick's Day for celebratory purposes. And in my house, it's fine. Oh, it is so cute. I don't have a lot of green palettes like this. This is a very unique palette, so I enjoy this one a lot. I haven't used it though, okay? But I enjoy looking at it. The color story is great. So next we have Nude Mood, which is stunning. I remember purchasing this and knowing I didn't need it, but I mean, look how pretty it is. Neutrals. I just love these neutral tones. Really pretty. This is a newer one from ColourPop. I think it's an exclusive with Ulta. So this one's probably gonna go out soon and not be sold much longer, but I love this one. I love the tones. And then also in that collection, we have Blush Crush. And this one is more pretty blushy tones. So these two, like I wanted to just pick one up, but I couldn't decide which one I liked better because they're both really stunning. So I got both and they're really good. I mean, ColourPop shadows are kind of pretty consistent across the board, so I know I'm going to like these. All right, so now we're gonna move on to Morphe. I've got to admit, Morphe is definitely my guilty pleasure. I do purchase and collect some of their palettes, not all of them. They don't have amazing quality, but I think they have some really fun color stories. And I'm not a big fan of affordable eyeshadows in general, but Morphe has one of the better formulas. So we have the 35i Icy Fantasy. I just featured this in a couple videos. I did a pastel tutorial and it was available one day, and then the next day I posted my tutorial and it was no longer available. So all of a sudden they just like got rid of this out of nowhere. No warning, no sales. It's just gone. I don't know what happened with that, but it is a really nice pastel palette. I think of course there are better formulas out there, but if you were looking to add pastels to your collection just kind of for fun, just to have them to mix it up, this one was a really nice one. I think some required a little bit of extra work, but that's okay. You know, there's inconsistencies in the formula in each of the colors, but you have so many different colors that it's fine for the price. So I liked this one a lot from Morphe. I thought it was really nice. We have the Morphe and Jeffree Star collaboration. I got a lot of heat on my video and I'm still getting a lot of heat from it because I didn't like it. I just didn't like the quality of this. I felt like Morphe has had much better formulas for these types of colors, and I mean, I'm gonna call it like it is. This palette wasn't that good. You could make it work sometimes, but there's some colors that truly I couldn't make work, and it is what it is. I wasn't a fan of this. This is currently on sale, but personally I was not into it. I think Morphe has better palettes. This was one of my first Morphe palettes and I had such a deep desire to pick it up. I loved it. This is from when I was in college, but I died for this palette. I thought it was so beautiful. I had to have it. I mean, looking back, most of these shimmers kind of look the same. Most of these browns kind of look the same, but back in the day, this was just a gorgeous palette to me. Neutral shimmers, are you kidding me? I didn't need that many matte shades because I was so in love with these shimmers. And I mean, they're good. I like this palette. I think it's a good palette. I think that it's a little bit too wet, so the colors kind of blend together. But for the most part, for a quick neutral eye, this is a good one. I haven't used it in a while, but I liked this one. This is the Morphe 3502. This is the second version of the really original 35O, which was so popular. I bought this on my 22nd birthday for myself. I remember I went to Dave & Buster's with my friend, and then we walked to Ulta, and this went on sale the day that my birthday happened. So I bought this for myself, even though 90% of the colors in here are the same, and I've only used this twice, and the reds really, really stained my eyelids. I do remember that. I don't know. I never used this palette, but I can't get rid of it, because at the same time, I just like really big palettes with a lot of shades. So shameless Morphe fan. We have the OG Jaclyn Hill palette, which truly is a good palette. I can't lie. You know I know my formulas and I do like this palette. I don't reach for it as much as I should just because I have so many eyeshadow palettes, but I have gotten some nice looks out of this. At this point, I feel like every look that has been created in the world has been created with this palette. It is a really good palette overall, and I definitely think it's a great starter palette for anybody and everybody. Of course, we have the volume 2. I did do a video with it and it's a bit bright for me. I don't know. I don't love the color story here, but I really did enjoy the looks that I got with this palette. I think the formula is pretty dang good, if I'm being honest. Everything was very pigmented. It blended very easily and the colors were gorgeous. I think I personally would prefer this palette to have some more shimmers because Jacqueline has a knack for shimmers. She always knows what a good shimmer is. I like this palette. If you like the colors, it's not a bad purchase at all. It's good quality. I also have the Vault. I got some good looks out of these, but the quality in here is not very good. I also struggled with the quality in here, but I made them work because they were pretty. So we have the Armed and Gorgeous. I love the tones in here. I thought this was a very, very unique palette. Like I said, all of these in some way, shape, or form were hard to work with, but that's okay. Dark Magic was probably the hardest to work with because these colors are difficult to formulate. I didn't do a very good job with it, but again, the color stories in here are so good. This is Bling Boss. I actually really, really like the shimmers in here. I think they're very, very pretty and very unique. And then this one is Ring the Alarm, which super warm. I don't really relate to this one. But yeah, no, the quality in here was not very good. I struggled, but at the same time, she does such a good job with picking colors. I was highly attracted to these palettes. I think they're so pretty. I have the 25A and the 25B. I talked about this recently in a video of palettes I can't get rid of. These kind of look the same. I ordered these in college because I was doing other girls' makeup, you know, for like sorority events and stuff, and I used Morphe on them back in the day. Again, 90% of the shadows are the same. I actually really liked these. These got a lot of use from me, and for nostalgia purposes, I just can't give these up because I discovered I loved doing other people's makeup while using these. So these actually have some sentimental value for me. Okay, also very embarrassing, but let's talk about the two giant Morphe palettes that I bought and never used. What even is this called? This is the 39S, such a gem. It's so stunning, but I've literally never used it. I bought it because you guys know I'm obsessed with pinks and purples, and even looking at it, I'm like obsessed with staring at it. But it's just like Morphe is, I don't know, I just haven't grabbed for it. I forgot about it, to be honest. I'm going to put this at the top of my drawer and I'm gonna use this very soon. And then we have the James Charles palette. I bought this when it first came out because I just felt like everybody and their mama owned it and was buying it, so I bought it and I've never used it, but I really should because I mean, it's a rainbow palette. I need to try it out, test out the beauty in this palette. So I mean, I am attracted to it and it's got a lot of colors and I think the concepts are really great. I wish I would have raided around and bought the mini one because this is ridiculously large and I can't believe I've never used it. This is embarrassing, but I just haven't. Okay, now we're gonna move into my BH Cosmetics. I don't have a ton from BH, but I really do like their palettes. I think they come out with some really cool, neat concepts. I bought this because Tati raved and raved about this. This is the Desert Oasis, and it is such a good palette. It is so pretty. The highlighters in here are spectacular. You have great color choices in here. I just think if you love a shimmery eye, you are going to love this palette. This is a really good one from BH, and the quality is there. The shiny colors are amazing. It works really great. I think this is overall a really good palette. So Desert Oasis, this performs like a high-end palette. Was also obsessed with this palette for years. This is the deluxe edition of the Carly Bible palette. And first of all, look how expensive that looks. It's so nice. And this again is another one that I used on others while I was doing makeup in college, but I also used it on myself. It's a gorgeous palette. The mauve tones, pinky, blushy, rosy. This is a stunning palette. And I wish they would do another one with Carly Bible because she did such a good job with this palette. It is truly stunning. I was obsessed with the highlighters for a long time and I don't think I can get rid of this. I have good memories behind this one. This is a good palette. We have Hanging in Hawaii. BH did a good job with this one. This one has really cute colors, these light pink rosy colors. I think the quality of this is pretty nice. It's not bad at all. I mean, you can tell it's not Pat McGrath by any means, but it is a good palette. And I do like the formulas and the color stories in all of the BH palettes, I think, are so pretty. They do a good job with their color stories. And this one I bought a few months back. I was celebrating, like, passing one of my teaching tests. And this is Summer in Saint-Tropez, and it's just a really bright, fun palette. I had some fun ideas for it, and I just never got around to doing it or filming that video. I do need actually play with it because looking at it, the colors are exciting me. This is an inspiring palette. Wow. I wonder if they still sell this. If they do, I need to do something with this palette because it's really pretty. I hope the quality is good. We're going to move on to Kaleidos. Yeah, if you don't know who Kaleidos is, they are a really cool makeup brand. They're an indie brand, but the concepts is very Pat McGrath-esque, very futuristic, very original. So this is the Futurism 1 Sci-Fi Green, and the quality on these are amazing. If you're interested in these palettes, they're so worth it. The quality is so good. Their shimmer formulas in particular are amazing, and look how beautiful the color story is, how original the packaging is. This is the Futurism 3 Astro Pink. This one's one of my favorites. The color story in here is insane. This color is insane. I love the neutral tones that they picked for this palette. I can't wait for Kaleidos to blow up because their stuff is everything. This is the Futurism 5 Electro Turquoise. Really, really fun for summer. Insane color right here. And just a really great color combo that they did. This is Futurism 2 Cyber Bronze. This one is a nice wearable one, kind of. If you're looking for like a bronze, kind of warm, smoky eye, I think you'll really like this. So if you're more of a neutral wear, this is the one I recommend. And it's just stunning. The last one that we have here is the VR Neon, which is a stunning neon palette. All of these are incredible. The concepts are so unique. Definitely recommend you pick these up. I love this brand. The people behind it are great. And I mean, look how awesome these are. So cool. I'm gonna move into Makeup Revolution. I own three. They're all collaboration palettes. Like Makeup Revolution shadows, to be honest. I've been through quite a few of them. I've decluttered quite a few. I've kept the collaborations, but this is the Soph X Ultra original eyeshadow palette. I like the formulation in here better than some of their other palettes. I do think it's better. I do think it is drugstore quality. Like, I can tell they're drugstore, but I do like, once you kind of dig into the shimmers, like, I can get a pretty look with this palette, and I love Soph does nails, so I keep them. And then I also have her second version, which is the Extra Spice. And again, I don't love the quality, but I love the creator behind it, and I love the color story behind it as well. So you can make these work. That's the important thing. You can get pretty looks out of these, but I don't love them. I don't love the quality. And then this one is the Rachel Leary Ultimate Goddess palette. And I don't watch her a lot, but I watched her enough to want to purchase this to support her. And truth be told, I really don't like the quality of this. I love the palette though itself. I think she chose beautiful colors. I tried hard to make this work for me. I couldn't. I only use it twice and I was just kind of disappointed with it, but I do need to try it again. Maybe I can make it work better for me another time. But from the two I've tried, I just couldn't make it work, and I need to try again because it's a really awesome palette. I love how big it is. I love the colors behind it. Again, Makeup Revolution, I just don't like their quality. There's something about their shadows that I don't like. Let's do NYX. NYX has a lot of palettes. I don't really purchase too many drugstore palettes, but I loved these. These are like their ultimate shadow palettes. I don't know if they even sell these anymore, but I like these because they're the same colors but different formulas, kind of the Tati style. But this came out before Tati, way before. NYX did it first, and I really, really like these. So this one is Warm Rust. I don't even know if they sell these anymore, but they're really good. I also picked up Sugar High, which is a little bit less warm, but I just really liked the concept behind these palettes, and I liked the quality. I thought the quality was decent, especially for drugstore. And this I probably could declutter. This is their Bright palette. I bought this one. I didn't have as many shadows as I had or as many rainbow palettes, so this got a lot of use from me in college when I would do crazy fun looks, or if I just needed a pop of a certain color, this palette had it. So this has some more nostalgia vibes for me, but it's a pretty good palette for rainbow. I'm not gonna lie, for the price and stuff, this was quite useful. All right, so we're gonna move on to Wet n Wild, my very humble one Wet n Wild eyeshadow that I own. And I know they have good ones, but I don't need those little palettes because I have like the high-end version of them. But this is Earth. This is from an old Zodiac collection. I bought the whole collection. This is the only one that has stood the test of time. I really like it. It's really pretty, great shimmers. I don't use it that often, but it's so pretty. And onto e.l.f. I have three shadows from them, which is crazy. And the third one I left in the drawer. These are so tiny, and it's a neutral one of these bite-sized ones. And I know a lot of you guys like the bigger ones. I do need to try those. I just have so many palettes that I resisted. But these are so cute, I couldn't. So this is Acai-U, and then we have Hot Jalapeno, I believe is what this is called, yes. And these are so cool, they're so tiny, they're so attractive. I don't think the quality in here is anything to write home about. I haven't used these, I'm just based off the swatches, but I do need to use these because I'm doing an update video and I just haven't gotten around to using these little cuties. So from what I can tell, these don't seem to be amazing, but these are also $3. And I just love the color concept behind these. I think they're adorable. We have two palettes from Olimar. I love their shadows. They are an indie brand and they're amazing. So this is the volume 2 of the Reina del Caribe. They only have two palettes. This is the second volume. And this one's a little bit harder to get a look out of, but it's a great palette to pair with other palettes. And then here's the original. I think these are very unique palettes. They're really fun and the formula on these are really awesome. So highly recommend you check out Olimar if these are speaking to you, and tropical vibes. They're so fun, so summery. I really enjoy their palettes, and you guys know every time they come out with something, I do support them and I do purchase their products because they're good, and I love it when my money goes to these smaller brands. I have two palettes from Juvia's Place. I want to get more, but I don't know. Their owner kind of seems crazy. I don't know if you guys have been watching that drama, but what? I don't know, but dang, she comes out with some good palettes. I want more, but I don't know. This is the Warrior palette. I mean, look how stunning that is, and the quality is very nice. And this is a neutral lover's dream. I mean, this is freaking stunning. I really like this. And then we have the Saharan by Juvia's, and again, this is just a fun one to try out different shades. And I mean, I really like the shadows. I think they're very, very good for the price and the concepts and the colors and the color story. Like, I want more from this brand. This is a new one. I haven't used it yet, but this is Nudes of New York from Maybelline. You know, I'm quite skeptical of drugstore shadows, but I heard good things about these. The swatches have left me intrigued, so I do need to use this and update you guys. But the colors do look very pretty, so we will see. So you guys saw me use this on camera. This is fairly new. This is the Most Wanted palette in Outlaw Olive, and I got a really pretty look out of this. I can tell it's drugstore. I don't love the quality of this, but it gets the job done, and it's a really pretty color story. So if you're into this color story and you're looking for something from the drugstore, I mean, this works. It's nice. And this is an oldie but a goodie. I really liked this one. This is the Most Loved matte, and it's just a really great matte palette from the drugstore. You get warm tones, mauve tones, and cool neutral tones, and I just really, really like this palette. I think it was a banger from the drugstore, truly. It did what it had to do. It was a nice one. So I do like these kind of palettes from Milani. They do a good job with those. And then I picked this up when I was on vacation at the drugstore, and I don't even know what this is called. The Gilded Rouge, I guess. I haven't used this, I'll be honest, but the color story here is insane, so I do need to use this. Like, ooh, okay, really, really pretty. And Milani's come out with some very pretty ones. These are what I just watched, by the way. So Ace Beauty is an indie brand, and I am in love with their color stories. So this is Paradise Fallen, and I mean, I haven't seen a purple palette like this, truly. I think it is so stunning, but my problem with Ace Beauty is I don't really like their quality. I find them hard to work with. This is Classical Paradise. Again, kind of those subculture vibes. So pretty, so unique. So I'm on the fence about these because I think that they do a beautiful job with the color story and the packaging and the whole theme and vibe. But the quality is also not very good. So I make these work because I like the colors, but I don't know. These hurt me because I just love the colors so much. So I have a giant all glitter palette. This is the Hypnotized palette from Pinky Rose Cosmetics. And I bought this again just to have some pressed glitters in my collection. I've only used this a few times because I don't use glitters as much as I used to, but this was just something for more artistic purposes, really, not actually to wear. And they have a lot of cool glitter palettes. So I saw this back in the day when Riley Rose wasn't closed down, and I liked it, so I bought it. This is a new one from Physicians Formula. This is Rose All Play. I bought this because I thought it looked like a step up for the drugstore, and I was incorrect. I don't really care for the quality of this. The shadows, from what I can tell, they're not very good. I've only used this once, so I do need to give it another chance and dig into it again because this is new. But see, I've been trying. I've bought a lot of drugstore shadows recently, but still, I'm not impressed. And the last palette that I have, this is actually a palette that I am very impressed by, and we're gonna finish off on a high note. This is the Profusion Sunkissed palette, and I really, really like this. This is really great for the price, and Profusion has a lot of beautiful palettes. You can pick them up at Walmart. I would recommend going to the store when all of this is over and taking a look. This is the Sunkissed palette. I think it's really pretty. I couldn't find this online, but I saw it in my store and I really like the colors in here. I think it's a very unique range of colors and you can get really pretty looks with this. So of course you can tell it's an affordable brand, but it's so good. I really like it. I think the colors in here are really pretty and I really would like to add to my collection for Profusion because they come out with beautiful palettes, beautiful color stories, and a really good formula for the price. So that is all I have for my affordable eyeshadow palette collection. I know I have a lot of high-end and luxury and I talk about it on my channel a lot, so I wanted to switch things up and show you that I do love affordable shadows as well. I love it when I can find a good deal for good quality and I don't speak about them enough on my channel. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you found it helpful. If there are any affordable brands or palettes that I need to check out, let me know. I love hinting you guys towards good affordable products. So thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure you check out my luxury and high-end palette collection as well. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye guys, have a good one.